Yang as him a call a piapo lone. Napuan caraco most well as a marble and a call a piapo lone. Be young one here, quite the edge
In a little more than a decade ago, the picture of the healthcare for the world's poorest was bleak. The simplest health issues, such as pregnancy, childbirth, cholera, or even malaria, could easily turn fatal. In Ghana, the government implemented the district health strategy, which ensured that each district capital in the country benefited from a health facility. But the project proved to be woefully inadequate and ineffective in areas where communities are located several kilometers apart. This means there was the need to extend coverage of basic and primary health services to the individual communities. It required reorientation and redeployment of health personnel from hospital-based activities to community-oriented activities. It also means more health workers needed to be trained to provide the badly needed support. And for this to happen, the government of Ghana launched community health planning services, simply called the CHPS compounds.
The CHPS compound system emanates from the primary healthcare concept. That is that we want to make health services available, accessible to the people at the community level. That every point in time, the health service is there, regularly at a community level. Accessible is that the people just quickly walk there and someone is there to give them the service. And then they themselves to own it because they have to be involved. That is why I talk about a promote community participation.
The issue about CHPS arose as a result of the Ghana Health Service and for that matter, government of Ghana's quest to bring health services to the doorstep of the masses of communities that are dotted around the country. And it also came as a result of the fact that we know that as a service, we really don't have enough personnel and for that matter, infrastructure deployed in various places where our people can easily access geographically health services that we provide.
We want to extend services to most rural communities, and that's the best way of sending services to the rural communities. CHPS compounds take care of a cluster of communities ranging between 4 to about 8. That is to make services clearly available to mothers and children.
As part of its Millennium Development Goals, Ghana was aiming at 100% easy access to healthcare for all people living in the country by the year 2015. It was hoping the CHPS concept would be the key. But as of now, more than half of the demarcated CHPS compounds in a country are still non-functional due to lack of drugs and other medical facilities.
This is our vital signs table. If you come, this is where we take our vital signs. As you can see, we do have equipment. The only equipment we can boast of here is the BP apparatus. That is the only thing I have, the thermometer.
Most of the women don't like delivering here because the place is not comfortable. Especially with the bed, they always complain it's too high for them. So others sometimes even prefer on the floor, so you have to be squatting and urinal, this thing in the toilet. We don't have it for the women who comes here. So when they are in labor, they say they want to feed themselves or something. You have to follow her into the bush to do that. We don't have a place for that.
The health insurance scheme is owing health facilities so many months. As we speak, The last time we were paid for these logistics were up to February this year. So from March onwards to now, we haven't had payments, and so supplies have been a challenge. And the supplies include drugs, you know, non-consumable items like bandages, plaster. All these are bought and have to be paid for. So our suppliers are becoming a bit skeptic about having to provide, you know, these essential commodities that are not being paid for. And so if you find our community, our chips compound, some of them may have run out of some of these supplies. And obviously nobody wants to go to a facility where you go and what they do is simply give you a prescription or a referral.
For the health workers to be able to deliver efficient and readily available health services to the communities, accommodation is key. Mariam Shahadu is a community health nurse. Her daily responsibilities includes visiting about 3 to 4 communities to deliver healthcare. But Mariam is not resident in any of the towns close by and has to ride on a motorcycle for several kilometers to meet her patients.
It's quite interesting and sometimes very stressful because you have to ride from your house to this place, and I stay in town, that's Guruku. So you ride to this place and park your motorbike and pick the facility motorbike and go to whichever village you want to go to, like this Napatua. When you are at Kumbungu, it's almost at Kumbungu. You go to that place, and certain times you'll be going, and the rain will meet you at on your way, where you not even see any house. You have to stand by a tree, so that after the rain is better, like it's not raining or something, you now go, or you just go through the rain. When you reach that community, you sit after the rain, you now run your outreach.
Cheap compounds have been sited without what? Accommodation. So it makes the work very difficult because the facility is there, the human resource is there, but where the person will go and lay the head is a challenge. But however, with the little support that we get with regards to the motor vehicles and other things, I could remember sometime last year, this assembly bought some motorbikes and gave them out to some of the cheap compounds, and the MP2 sometime also bought some motorbikes and they were distributed to some of the cheap compounds. Not all the cheap ones, but there were a limited number that we had.
But most of the motorcycles giving out to the health workers to ease their movements to the communities have broken down under pressure. The few left are also faulty.
The motorbikes that we have given them, unfortunately, haven't been the best quality motorbikes. And therefore, a lot of the time, they suffer breakdowns. The chief officers suffer breakdowns of the motorbikes. And therefore, recently, at our district director's conference, in annual conference in Bolga, we made a passionate appeal to the ministry, and for that matter, through the Ghana Health Service Director General, you know, that they should take a second look at the transport policy of buying the type of motorbikes that are provided to us to be given to these chief officers. Are not the best. We have been using these Chinese motorbike called Nanfang that are not reliable.
You go and you can't come back with it. You have to pack it. But always we maintain it, but we don't know. The Nanfang, the white ones. Even the footrest, when you mean to go into. When someone pick me, I can't put my foot there. I have to raise it this way. So we get there. When you even go out, you see it. So the motorbike there is it's very serious. It's just an issue for us.
These frustrations encountered by some health workers in accessing the distant communities has resulted in the near abandonment of the outreach program, as the community health nurses rather sit and wait for patients to come to them.
The idea of the chief compound is not to turn them to hospitals or clinics. Unfortunately, that's what it seems to be currently. Instead of the community health officer going around the community, they rather are resident, making the compound look like a clinic, and where they expect people to come. But that defeats the purpose of CHPS. Because the purpose is that our people, where they are located, our communities are smaller communities, but they are dotted several kilometers apart. And so transportation from their communities to the CHPS compound is a problem. And that is why the issue of CHPS arose, because we wanted to actually reduce this geographical or improve on the geographical access to health services. That is why we have asked that community health officer should be resident there and giving the support, including motorbikes, where they will use these motorbikes to move from one community to another. But because of the fact that some of them have turned the CHPS compound into clinics, they sit there and they expect the community people to journey to them. So the problem that we're trying to solve has not been adequately resolved or solved, because the community people will have to find transport still to come to the CHPS compound. And that is why patronage in some of these places will be low.
The provision of accommodation attached to the CHPS compounds remains the best option to help the health workers have easy and ready access to the communities, a responsibility which lays solely on the doorstep of the district assemblies.
As far as the district assembly is concerned, they provide the hardware. And here we're talking about the infrastructure. Now, in providing the infrastructure, there's the need to consult the Ghana Health Service so that they will be able to know the right kind of structure that CHPS compound needs.
Ideally, the disassemblies are mandated to provide these infrastructure development, where they put up these compounds, mainly just some two-room accommodation, where one room is used for accommodating the staff who work there, and the other room where they can keep their logistics, and sometimes also attend to minor ailments. But that's where the challenge is. A lot of our disassemblies don't have the requisite finances to put up these compounds.
Compounds here are built by the assembly. They are built by the assembly. But it becomes the responsibility of the health sector, GHS, Ghana Health Service, to provide the staff. So now what we expect the communities to do is to support us, support the chief's officer in terms of labor, providing them even security, to make the CHPS compound very lively, to clean the place, support to disseminate information, support to recruit people, lead the CHPS officers to the community.
But getting the community to assist in the operation and management of these CHPS compounds involves more than mere talk. In an area where the level of illiteracy is high, dialogue and education is essential in helping the community understand their role in sustaining the CHPS compounds. This is where the Center for Active Learning and Integrated Development, CALID, comes in.
The role we are playing in as far as the CHPS compound is concerned is how to get the CHPS compound functional. CALID is doing this through community sensitization. It's also doing it through engagement with the duty bearers. It's also doing the through radio discussions. We are also doing it through a kind of resource tracking, and then also trainings with the trainings for the community volunteers and the community health officers, because the two work hand in hand. So whatever we are doing, we don't want it to look like we are too much on the side of the community and then leaving the community health nurses. So whatever we are doing, we try to ensure that they are equally on the same footing.
With the support of some NGOs now, we've been able to set up the community health committees to support the chief center. So we have started building and making sure that they now take up their roles and responsibility in supporting to make sure that the chief's compound grow into what we are thinking of.
We also have to let them know, and that is where NGOs come in, and I keep saying that you identify a problem in your place, how do we solve it together? So it's also the rule, you also have the rule that NGOs and say that, let, I don't say it alone, you also tell the community people, you also tell the chief this compound belongs to you and your people. It doesn't belong to the director. It doesn't belong to the doctor sitting behind there. So you support them, and then we keep it as your property, and then use it for your people. That is what I think we should all be doing.
How is the community and the assembly like? Is the assembly helpful in the community? Or do we go to them when we need help? And when we go, do they come to our aid?
Yes, but you are a year to me, can assembly, Kawala, Chunkiera. Assembly soon now. Be a kind of a tarayala, a gun assembly. Mamma, I'm swinging.
Malue is a perfect example of a community that has understood the CHPS concept and continues to work to keep the compound operational.
I've not been here for long, but when I came, I heard a lot about them. Like, they provide a fridge for us to put in our vaccines and drugs. And I heard they provide 3 beds, one for the patients and 2 for the nurses around. Without the lights or without the fridge, even if there's light and there's no fridge, we can't save it, we can't keep it here for long. And for the best, we do detain, we take deliveries, and the pregnant women too. That's where we examine them, so it's very helpful.
I must say that in my district, for instance, there have been 3 communities that have been so exemplary. When we raise the issue of accommodation challenges, they volunteer to, mobilize labor, to put up some accommodation facilities. They are not the best, but I must appreciate their effort, because, for instance, there's a place called Katani where the chief and the people around there came out and built a 4-unit accommodation for my staff. And it is not the type of accepted kind of accommodation, but a little more decent than what the community people themselves have been occupying. And I think that is the best, one example that is worth emulating. If we can find the communities doing that, then definitely we will have been solving the issue of accommodation, faster than having to depend solely on government and, for that matter, the disassemblies.
We are here because of the community. The clinic belongs to the community, so we need them to come on board. That is why when the NGO came, we were happy. They came and put in place the health committee. So now when we want to get to the community, we go to the committee. So it has made things a little bit better, a little bit easier.
After a series of educational programs organized by CALID for the chiefs and elders of the Nambalat community, these rooms within the palace were released by the chief to be used temporarily as a chief's compound.
Chen Kansla Kabumbanting Yatava Halakar to Pab Kamna Yong, and Telan Yong the Mint Tung Panser Katazalan Pika, Biani, Biani, Bentiti daughter Kadamar Halakavati daughter Kana to your daughter Wapi, Tinakati and Zamban no share, Katra Zamban and to Chongma to you dry and Taba.
After months of lobbying, funds have been released by the District Assembly for the construction of a CHPS compound with an attached accommodation for health workers who would be posted to the area. The completion of the facility would mean that the community members would not have to travel long distances to access basic health care.
Even from my community, I Wawani, Yo, Safam, we are very far. My place is, even at this time, during the rainy season, it will be about 21 kilometers to Diari, which was the nearest facility we have, health facility we have to go. And the Nambala us from here is about 10 kilometers to the nearest facility. So as they've opened this facility here, it has helped us in a lot that we all gather here, where the communities that are involved gather here and then do attend the clinics here.
Through the initiative of CALID, more and more communities are beginning to accept their role in owning and managing the CHPS compounds through communal labor, fundraising, amongst others, in support of the CHPS.
And that will not only depend on the good work of the officers here, but you as well. It will be difficult for us to turn this place into a health center. But if all the collaboration is coming, I'm happy that you are saying that now you are collaborating effectively with them and you see them as your children. And
that when they come, they are always all the time standing in the sun. So from there, we decided to put up this shed and then even to grow trees so that we can get shade. We grow all these trees here so that we can, in future, we can get some shade to stay under.
Most communities who own CHPS compounds have also set up health committees who meet regularly to discuss issues relating to the health of the community and how they as health volunteers can help to improve upon service delivery at the CHPS compounds. Al-Hassan Al-Hassan is one such volunteer at the Cheshegu Health Center. When Mariam goes out on outreach duties, Al-Hassan keeps the fort by assisting to register patients and getting them ready for consultation.
We make sure that the environment is kept clean, as well as inside the CHPS compound. I go around with the community health Nash to other communities for weighing sessions.
CALID train us on budget, on the CHPS compound, how they get the money from the CHPS compound, and how they spend it, and how the work is going on. So, in fact, it's just good on the training, how we had it from that budget training. Well, I'm a volunteer here, and I'm also meeting them at all times to find out how they spend the money. At times, even director comes here to ask them of how they get the money and how they spent it.
The initiative by CALID to increase community level involvement in the provision of basic health services, dubbed Community Action on Resource Allocation and Management of CHPS, is expected to encourage community participation, build capacity of volunteers, and increase collaboration between key stakeholders in 35 communities in 7 districts, including the Tamale Metropolis, the Sangnarigu District, Tolon District, Kumbugu District, Savelugu Nanton District, Bole District, and the Sola Tuna Kalba District. Various engagements with the communities through sensitization meetings have improved the knowledge and understanding of the communities. More communities are beginning to set up and take responsibility for the operation of the compounds. But that is not all.
Patients come, there's no toilet and bath. We have problem, we don't have, you know, OPD cars, folders for the patients. You have to be treating patients with PPS. We have telling you with the chest case, HIV test case are not there. So when pregnant women come, you can't tell them to establish whether they are HIV positive or negative. So during delivery, how will you be able to know? Meanwhile, the HIV test case is not even here from here to the district level. Malaria test case are not there. Some have just been come. So if people come, about 200 people come within a month, you treated about 180 for malaria with a test case. How are you sure whether all of them are malaria cases? Because health insurance are not paying regularly. You go to a district level because they also owe region. They can't go to bring drugs. We also go there, we can't get drugs. Somebody walk far away from the village. The person has come for treatment. You get only one drug for the person. The person will be disappointed. Tomorrow the person will not come back.
Three things.
Nobody would want to visit a facility where they are not sure of the quality of the service provider. So we need to deploy a lot more trained personnel. That's number one. Number two, we need to also make provision of the logistics, drugs and attend. The supply of drugs are key. That will build the confidence. The third thing that we need to also make sure that we have is the issue of our staff being comfortable. So the issue of CHPS compound cannot be run, cannot be relegated to the background. And to do that, the assemblies must be empowered. And when I say empowerment, talking about financial empowerment, they must be up and doing in providing these CHPS compounds that are decent enough and assuring enough for our staff to be able to be accommodated there, so they can also have a good night rest, and the following day they can be up and doing, moving around the community, providing the needed services. If these three issues are looked at critically and are provided, I can assure you that our community people will be very, very, very happy in patronizing the services that were provided in these CHPS areas.
We expect that they, at the end of the day, they actually do not relax. They don't see it to be like somebody's job. They see it as their own job, and then they are also supporting in the development of their own communities.
To ensure an improvement in the access to basic health, a greater community participation is needed. The district assemblies and the Ghana Health Service also need to set up their responsibilities in providing accommodation and medical resources respectively.